Guys, a little bit of a tour of our van. So we're gonna start in the trunk, and this is where we keep all of our cooking stuff and our food supplies. So we have our little barbecue here stored on top of the fridge. This thing is clutch when you wanna do any sort of cooking while camping. It's just like 10 out of 10, love it. So we're gonna take that out. And usually like when you arrive somewhere, I'll just like take this and put it where we're gonna be cooking. Okay, so after you set up and put your like, I don't know, barbecue, wherever you're gonna put your barbecue, you have access to your fridge. And this fridge is, it's not just like a cooler, it's an actual fridge. So it's powered by this really huge battery bank that can go for about 3 or 4 days without being charged. But while you're actually driving, the battery bank is charged by the car. So yeah, if you actually come here, you can see all the stuff we have in our fridge. So we have all of our treats, leftovers. We have some vegetables, pasta, salad, peanut butter, and a bunch of vodka sodas because that is how we roll. So yeah, that is the fridge. And then here we have a little composting container. So any like food waste that we have while camping, we put in here and we will dispose of responsibly later. In here we have all of our cooking supplies. So we have, you guys saw me use the jet boil earlier this morning, and then we have like pots and pans and I don't know, anything you could need, some cleaning supplies. And yeah, that's kind of the back of the van. It's a pretty simple setup, and there is an alternative setup for this where you actually have a full water tank here and then like a kitchen unit, but we took it out for this trip because we really wanted to bring the barbecue. So the barbecue reigns supreme for this one. But let's go around and show you the sleeping part of the van. So this is where we sleep in the van, and this is the janky tarp that we put up last night because it's like 100% chance it's gonna rain tonight, so we wanted to be prepared. But this is sort of like my side of the bed here. And basically what this is a custom built unit for this Dodge. And this little unit here basically folds up and folds out into a bed. So there's a mattress here. And underneath we have a whole bunch of storage. And this is sort of like the pantry. So where I got all of my like mustards yesterday, those are all stored there, snacks. And we also pack down all of our blankets and stuff under here as well when we're driving. So it's really nice for, yeah, storage. Storage is like everything in van life because otherwise things get really disorganized. So this is my sleeping bag here. It's honestly so cozy in here, and we have these like little twinkly lights. And this is our water supply that is completely out, so we're gonna go and refill that later today. And then there's also more storage like on either side of this like center console. So when you're sleeping, basically you have to move all of your bags from in the back of the van to the front of the van or under, so you have enough room to sleep. But it's super cozy, and it feels honestly way more secure than being in a tent. Whenever I'm tent camping, I'm always like very nervous about bears because that's a real thing here in Canada. And when you're in the van, there's just like such a greater sense of security, which I really, really like. It helps me sleep better. So yeah, that is the sleeping area of the van. And the front seats right now are kind of just holding all of our window coverings. Again, in my last vlog, I showed you guys like how we put those up. Oh, and one other actually really key thing. So this little, I don't know if you guys can see it, but there's a little power bank here with our phone chargers. So this power bank is strong enough to charge our laptops, straightening irons for your hair if you really wanted to straighten your hair while camping. And there's another power bank in the back that actually charges the fridge that I showed you before, and that one's like way bigger. This is like the little baby one. That's pretty much it, I think, for the van. So this is my first time using this van by myself. Again, this is Evan's van, and he was so nice to let us borrow it for this trip. So I'm still learning the ropes and learning everything about van life and van camping, but because of 2020, I foresee a lot more of this in the future. So I'm excited to sort of learn the ropes and learn more about how to optimize the van life or van travel.